friends, today we will learn about RS factor. Many people have the RS factor on the red blood cell. RS carriers do not have the RS carrier do not have the antibodies for the RS factor, but can make them if exposed to RH. Most commonly, RH is seen when anti-RH antibody cross from the mother placenta to the child from before birth. The RH factor enters the child, destroying the child's red blood cells. This is called hemolytic disease. Hemolytic disease of the newborn. Often, normally, a pregnant woman carries a fetus with a different blood type to herself, and sometimes the mother forms antibodies against the RBC of the fetus, leading to low fetus blood counts and condition known as hemolytic disease of the newborn baby. Hemolytic disease of the newborn is an alloimmune condition that develops in a fetus when the IgG antibodies produced by the mother and passing through the placenta include ones which attack the RBC in the fetal circulation. The red cells are broken down and fetus can develop reticulocytosis and anemia. And the fetal disease ranges from mild to very severe, and fetal death from heart failure, hydrofetalis can occur. When the disease is moderate or severe, many erythroblasts are present in the fetal blood, and so these forms of the disease can be called erythroblastosis fetalis. Before birth, options for treatment include intrauterine transfusion or early induction of labor when pulmonary maturity has been attained, fetal distress is present, or 35 to 37 weeks of gestation have passed. The mother may also undergo plasma exchange to reduce the circulating levels of antibodies by as much as 75%. After birth, treatment depends on the severity of the condition, but could include temperature stabilization and monitoring, phototherapy, transfusion with compatible packed RBC, exchange transfusion with a blood type compatible with both the infant and the mother, sodium bicarbonate for correction of acidosis, or assisted ventilation. RH negative mothers who have had a pregnancy with or are pregnant with a RH positive infant are given RH immune globulin, also known as Rogam, during pregnancy and after delivery to prevent sensitization to the D antigen. It works by binding any fetal red cells with the D antigen before the mother is able to produce an immune response and form anti-D IgG. Let's know about RH antigen, that is RH plus and RH minus people. Both about 85% of all white people are RH plus and 15% RH negative. In American blacks, the percentage of RH plus is about 95%, and whereas in African blacks it is virtually 100%. There are 6 common type of RH antigen, each of which is called RH factor. These type are designated C, D, E, capital C, capital D and capital E. A person who has a C antigen does not have the small C antigen. Means capital C, if a person who has a capital C antigen does not have a small C antigen, but the permission missing the capital C antigen always has the small antigen. The same is the truth for D, capital D and small d, and in case of capital E and small e antigens. Also, because of the manner of inheritance of these factors, each person has one of each of the three pairs of antigens. The type capital D antigen is widely prevalent in the population and considerably more antigenic than the other Rh antigens. Anyone who has this type of antigen is said to be to the Rh plus, whereas a person who has not have type capital D antigen is said to be Rh. However, it must be noted that even in Rh negative people, some of the other Rh antigen can still cause transfusion reactions, although the reactions are usually much milder. Now come to compatibility in blood transfusions. Blood transfusions between donor and recipient of incompatible blood types can cause severe acute immunological reactions, hemolysis, that is RBC destruction. Hemolysis means RBC destruction of RBC, renal failure, shock and sometimes death. Antibodies can be highly active and can attack RBCs and bind components of the complement system to cause massive hemolysis of the transfused blood. A patient should ideally receive their own blood or type-specific blood products to minimize the chance of a transfusion reaction. If time allows, the risk will further be reduced by cross-matching blood in addition to blood typing both recipient and donor. Cross-matching involves mixing a sample of recipient's blood with a sample of donor's blood and checking to see if the mixture agglutinates or forms clumps. Blood bank technicians usually check for agglutination with a microscope, and if it occurs that particular donor's blood cannot be transfused to that particular recipient. Blood transfusion is a potentially risk medical procedure, and it is vital that all blood specimens are correctly identified. So, in cross-matching, labeling is standardized using a barcode system known as ISBT-128. Let's know about diseases of the blood. Disseminated intravascular coagulation, in short, DIC, also called congestive coagulopathy, is a pathological process in the body where the blood starts to coagulate through the whole body. This depletes the body of its platelets and coagulation factors, and there is a paradoxically increased risk of hemorrhage. It occurs in critically ill patients, especially those with gram-negative sepsis, meningococcal sepsis, and acute promyelocytic leukemia. Now come to hemophilia. Hemophilia is a disease where there is low or no blood protein, causing an inability to produce blood clots. There are two types of hemophilia, that is type A and type B. Type A, which is a deficiency factor VIII, and type B is a deficiency factor IX. Because people with hemophilia do not have the ability to make blood clots, even a little cut may kill them, and the smallest bump or jar to the body could cause severe bursting that does not gel between better for months. Hemophilia is passed down from mothers to their sons. Hemophilia is sometimes known as royal disease. This is because Queen Victoria, Queen of England, in 1837-901 was carried off hemophilia. The hemophilia disease was passed down to her son Leopold, who ended up dying at age 31. Queen Victoria also had two daughters who were the carriers. These daughters passed hemophilia into the Spanish, German and Russian royal families. One of the most famous stories is that the Russian royal family, Alexandra, granddaughter to Queen Victoria, married Nicholas, Tsar of Russia, in 1900. Yes. Alexandra was a carrier of the disease and passed the disease to their first son, Tsarevich Alexei, who was heir to the throne of Russia. The family tried to keep their son secret from the people, but Alexei suffered with serious bruises and extreme pain. The family found help from a monk named Rasputin. He kept their secret and gained a great deal of power over the family, making them think he was their only hope. During this time of great turmoil in Russia, Nicholas and Alexandra spent most of their attention on their son and not on the people. It was not long before the Bolshevik Revolution of 1917 began. Factor B laden. The opposite of hemophilia factor B laden is the name given to a variant of human factor V that causes a hypercoagulability disorder. In this disorder, the laden variant of the factor V cannot be inactivated by activated protein capital C. Factor B laden is the most common hereditary hypercoagulability disorder amongst Eurasians. It is named after the city Leiden, that is the Netherlands, where it was first identified in 1994 by Prof. R. Bertina, et al. Those that have it are at a slightly higher risk of developing blood clots than those without. Those that test positive for factor B should avoid. Means oral contraceptive, obesity, smoking and high blood pressure. It should be avoided. Let's come to know about anemia. Anemia, from the Greek, meaning without blood, refers to a deficiency of RBC, hemoglobin. RBC or hemoglobin. This results in a reduced ability of blood to transfer oxygen to the tissues, causing hypoxia. Since all human cells depend on oxygen for survival, varying degree of anemia can have a wide range of clinical consequences. Hemoglobin has to be present to ensure adequate oxygenation of all body tissues and organs. The three main classes of anemia include excessive blood loss acutely, such as a hemorrhage, or chronically through low volume loss. Excessive blood destruction, that is hemolysis, or deficient red blood cells production, that is ineffective hematopoiesis. In menstruating women, dietary iron deficiency is a common cause of deficient red blood cell production. Now let's know about sickle cell. Sickle cell disease is a general term for a group of genetic disorders caused by sickle hemoglobin, that is HGBS. In many forms of disease, the red blood cells change the shape upon oxygenation because the polymerization of the abnormal sickle cell hemoglobin. This process damages the red blood cell membrane and can cause the cells to become stuck in blood vessels. This deprives the downstream tissues of oxygen and causes ischemia infraction. The disease is chronic and lifelong. Individuals are most often well, but their lives are punctuated by periodic painful attacks. In addition to periodic pain, there may be damage of internal organs and stroke. Lifespan is often shortened, with sufferers living to an average of 40 years. It is common in people from parts of the world where malaria is common, especially in sub-Saharan Africa or in descendants of those peoples. Sickle cell disease is inherited in autosomal recessive pattern depicted above like this. The allele responsible for sickle cell anemia is autosomal recessive. A person who receives a defective gene from both father and mother develops the disease. A person who receives a defective and one healthy allele remains the healthy, but can pass one disease and is known as carrier. If two parents who are carriers have a child, there is a one in four chances of their child developing the illness and a 1 in 2 chance of the child just being a carrier. Let's know about polycythemia. Polycythemia is a condition in which there is a net increase in total circulating erythrocytes, RBC, mass of the body. There are several types of polycythemia, like primary polycythemia and secondary polycythemia, relative polycythemia, like this. Let's know about primary polycythemia. In primary polycythemia, there may be 8 to 9 million and occasionally 11 million erythrocytes per cubic millimeter of blood, and the hematocrit may be as high as 70 to 80%. In addition, the total blood volume can increase to as much as twice as normal. The entire vascular system can become markedly engorged with blood, and circulation times for blood throughout the body can increase up to twice a normal value. The increased numbers of erythrocytes can increase the viscosity of the blood to as much as 5 times normal. Capillaries can become plugged by the very viscous blood, and the flow of blood through the vessels tends to be extremely sluggish. As a consequence of the consequences, people with untreated polycythemia are at a risk of various thrombotic events, heart attack and stroke, and have a substantial risk of bird chiari syndrome. The condition is considered chronic. No cure exists for this. Symptomatic treatment can normalize the blood count and most patients can live a normal life for years. Secondary polycythemia is caused by either appropriate or inappropriate increases in production of erythropoietin that result in an increased production of erythrocytes. In secondary polycythemia, there may be 6 to 8 million and occasionally 9 million erythrocytes per cubic millimeter of blood. A type of secondary polycythemia in which the production of erythropoietin increases appropriately is called physiological polycythemia. Physiologic polycythemia occurs in individuals living at high altitude, where oxygen availability is less than at sea level. Many athletes train at higher altitudes to take advantage of this effect, a legal form of blood doping. Actually, polycythemia sufferers have been known to use their condition as an athletic advantage for greater stamina. Other causes of secondary polycythemia include smoking, renal or liver tumors, or heart or lung diseases that result in hypoxia. Let's know about relative polycythemia. Relative polycythemia is an apparent rise of erythrocyte level in the blood. However, the underlying cause is reduced blood plasma. Relative polycythemia is often caused by fluid loss, that is burns, dehydration and stress polycythemia. Now let's know about leukemia. Leukemia is a cancer of the blood or bone marrow characterized by an abnormal proliferation of blood cells, usually white blood cells. It is part of the broad group of disease called hematological neoplasms. Damage of the bone marrow by way of displacing the normal marrow cells with increasing numbers of malignant cells results in a lack of blood platelets, which are important in the blood clotting process. This means people with leukemia may become bruised, bleed excessively, or develop pinprick bleeds. White blood cells, which are involved in fighting pathogens, may be suppressed or dysfunctional, putting the patient at the risk of developing infections. The red blood cells deficiencies leads to anemia, which may cause dyspnea. All symptoms may also be attributable to other diseases. For diagnosis, blood test and bone marrow biopsy are required. Thank you.